Welcome back. Now, this one is quite like the David and Goliath fable. On one side was Facebook, a company whose market cap is greater than the GDPs of 144 countries, allied with a bunch of big telcos. And together, they were offering free internet to a billion Indians who could not afford it otherwise. But then it came with a caveat. Facebook would decide which websites could be accessed on this platform. They even had a massive ad campaign that estimates put at 400 crore rupees. On the other side, of course, there was a motley group of internet activists. There were entrepreneurs involved in it as well, and very often individual voices. Early last week, telecom regulator TRAI ruled that no company is going to offer or charge discriminatory tariffs for data on the basis of content. That ruling, firmly in favor of net neutrality, has subsequently forced Facebook to make a total retreat and shut down Freebasics in India. So what went wrong for Facebook over here? Can the brand really recover from this debacle? We ask the experts in this story.
Once the poster boy of a new, free and fearless world of social media, Facebook has been facing flak in India over the past year over its Freebasics platform. Formerly known as internet.org, the platform would provide free but restricted internet access to almost a billion Indians with the help of a few telecom giants. This later became the center of a heated battle over net neutrality, with internet activists, politicians and the general public all in the fray. But early last week, telecom regulator TRAI ruled against differential pricing by telecom companies, effectively putting the brakes on zero-rating platforms like Freebasics.
Packets on internet, the pipes should not decide, pipes should be agnostic to the packets.
The move has been generally welcomed, especially for internet-based services, which could have faced a grave struggle for existence otherwise.
I think we are one of the leading app players over here in this market with 100 million plus users. And the very reason that I am sitting here and talking to you, and the very reason where 100 million plus users are utilizing Truecaller, is because of one single genesis called net neutrality. So we assume that net neutrality in whatever avatar, it has to be free, it has to be equal, and the right of usage and the right to utilize internet should lie in the hands of the users. And I think better sense has prevailed, and we're really thankful to have taken a very robust stand on this subject, giving equal opportunity to all sets of parties involved in this discussion or the debate, and coming to a very good conclusion.
Facebook subsequently had to shut down Freebasics in India. But with 130 million Facebook users, 375 million people online, and additionally almost a billion who aren't, India is the biggest growth market for the social network, which remains blocked in China. So how badly could this debacle hurt the brand's image in this key market?
Well, obviously Facebook has put so much effort behind, Freebasics in India. I mean, and this is the second time, the internet org was the first one, and now this. I think clearly there's for them this takes it's a knock, because it was such a public campaign and there was so much investment from Zuckerberg downward, that obviously there is loss of face involved. There is a sense of having tried really hard and very visibly having failed. So to that extent, Facebook as a brand will today be a little less confident and a little more vulnerable than it was in the past. I think it's a really strongly entrenched brand. It has a relationship. It has a very kind of a significant relationship with its Indian users. So I don't think it's in any imminent danger of any kind beyond the fact that it now is a little more vulnerable to its public face. I think has become faces challenges, I think, today more than it has in the past.
What stands out in the debate over net neutrality is the fact that Facebook was being opposed by a motley crew of individuals who took to social media and even Facebook itself to protest against Freebasics. Facebook in turn launched a massive 360-degree campaign across media, one that cost it almost 400 crores. But the move seems to have backfired. So where did Facebook go wrong?
Even the digital brands, which come from a different world, which is more democratic, where the brute force of money is not employed, but the instinct of large corporations is that when pushed, when in doubt, you eventually throw big advertising at the problem, and which is what Facebook did. That they threw big money and conventional advertising, at a problem that you know, whereas they are the preeminent digital player in India, and in spite of that, when it came to the crunch, like any other large corporation, they threw money at the problem. In this case, it didn't work.
But given that India is a country that has been struggling with connectivity for well over a decade now, some feel that the vehement opposition to Facebook Freebasics was premature and an overreaction, while others believe that a wait-and-watch approach could have cost India dearly.
It's quite possible that Facebook would spend a lot of money on Freebasics and get not much. Companies do stupid things too. Maybe consumers benefit from the stupid things companies do. But instead, the debate in India has turned into all-knowing evil Facebook is going to control the internet. We have no evidence for that.
I've heard that. I've heard it said that, well, you know what's wrong? Let's try. We could have tried it for 1 year or 5 years. My point is, yeah, sure, you know, it's poison. We could have tried it for 1 year or 5 years. Then we could have figured out how many died. And it's a dead few die or did a lot die. Then we'd decide whether we should keep it going. I mean, we know clearly it's poison. Every experience of the Freebasics experience around the world has been shown to that it is poisonous. And, you know, the poor 36 countries that are around the world, I hope they now change their mind, taking the lead from India in terms of banning Freebasics. Egypt has already done so. I hope the others follow suit soon. That's really the first part. The second part that's brought up is, you know what, it's all the people with internet who have now determined that the poor should not get free internet. That's also nonsense. It's ridiculous. This move is not an anti-poor move. It's an, you know, unless you call Zuckerberg poor and Sunil Bharti Mittal poor, it's not anti-poor. It's basically anti-colonial. It's stopping the colonization moves that Airtel and Zuckerberg were trying. It's saying, look, go back with your own legitimate business. We're perfectly cool with what you are.